the first piece or the first piece of agenda for the day, and that is what Cabinet has done, which has approved a relief package for the beleaguered telecom industry. Operators now have more time to pay back their spectrum liabilities and can hold more spectrum as well. Confused? Well, let's get in Darshan to tell you and simplify this and what it means for the existing telcos. Darshan, good morning.
Yeah, good morning. So basically, yesterday the cabinet meet was there in which they simplified some rules which will benefit the telecom operators, at least the incumbent, not Jio so much. So firstly, there were two things that they did. The first thing that they did was that they extended the spectrum payment period from the earlier 10 years to 16 years, so they get an additional 6 years to pay back, the government for the spectrum. And secondly is relaxed spectrum holding cap, which I will talk about later. The first move that they did, let's take a look at, what the current scenario is. So when you buy spectrum, 50% has to be paid upfront, then there is a two-year moratorium, and then the balance 50% is to be paid back over the next 10 years. Now, what has happened is this 10 years has been moved to 16 years. That means, for paying the balance 50%, they will have an additional 6 years. Now, nothing in terms of that will actually help them increase their cash flow and manage the capex. Basically, their balance sheet will be repaired significantly because they have 6 more years to actually pay back this spectrum. So that's the first thing, and that will benefit all the telecom companies. Now, the second thing that they did is the relaxing of spectrum caps. So the overall cap, currently the cap is at 25%. They made it 35%, but currently no one has close to 25%. The second one was initially they had a band-wise cap. So each band had a 50%. Now what they've done is combined all the bands, and they say that, on a combined cap will be 50%. Now this benefits, companies like Idea Cellular and Vodafone, which have excess spectrum because of the merger that will come in. Now, if you're looking at the combined spectrum, excess spectrum, so in Maharashtra as well as Gujarat, Kerala, Haryana, UP. So this is the Idea Vodafone combined spectrum. So initially what happened is if you had excess spectrum, either you had to return it to the government or find a buyer. And it will be difficult to find a buyer because anyway there was excess spectrum. So overall expect, Jio won't benefit significantly from this, but expect Bharti Airtel and Idea to react positively to the news that has come out yesterday.
And it's twin good news for the Vodafone Idea combined, right? Both the pieces of news impacts Vodafone Idea in a positive
way. The first piece helps both Airtel and Idea, and Idea Vodafone, I'm talking about the combined entity. And secondly, will definitely help them once the merger happens, because then they will not have to actually sell the spectrum or give it back to the government. They can keep it with them. So that's the positive.
That should be interesting. They've been beaten down so badly, Darshan. Should be interesting to see what happens to these stocks today. Remember, if we just pull up the one-week chart for both Bharti as well as Idea, and Bharti in particular, I remember because we've been talking about it every day or almost every day when we do the heat map as to the quantum of fall that we've seen in Bharti Airtel. Look at this. Last 7 days, about 4.5%. And in fact, if you take from the peak, I think it's about a 6% or a 7% drop that we've seen in Bharti Airtel over the last 7 days, over the 10 days even more so. So it's not been a great period if you're a Bharti shareholder. Maybe, just maybe, a bit of a relief rally. Don't know if it'll last or no, but likely that will be a bit of a relief rally that we see in Bharti Airtel in the session today. Maybe, Idea Cellular probably even more so.